وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى in this tafsir session, إن شاء الله تعالى I want to do the آيات first six verses of سورة مريم. قال الله جل وعلا، الله says كافها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا وإني خفت الموالي من ورائي وكانت امرأتي عاقرا فهب لي من لدنك وليا يرثني ويرث من آل يعقوب وجعله ربي رضيا. The surah starts with كاف ها يا عين صاد. And these letters are called حروف المقطعة. It's called حروف المقطعة. These letters in which many surahs in the Quran have come with them, like حاميم, ألف لام ميم, ألف لام راء, صاد, نون, قاف, عين سين, حاميم, عين سين, قاف. All of these حروف, they're called حروف المقطعة. They start with several surahs in the Quran. الله أعلم بمراده. Allah knows what he means by it, سبحانه وتعالى. But the scholars, they mention the wisdom of why Allah used it, سبحانه وتعالى. And they say that the wisdom is to show the Arabs who were there when the Quran came down, to say to them, this Quran that you guys see Muhammad reciting, it consists of these letters. كاف, ها, يا, عين, صاد. These letters that you know, it's these letters that the Quran consists of. And with that being said, you guys are still unable to come with the likes of this Quran. It's in the language that you guys know. It's in the alphabets that you guys are aware of. مع ذلك, you're unable to come with the likes of this Quran. ولذلك, the majority of the places that these حروف المقطعة are mentioned, right after it, Allah generally mentions the Quran or something related to the Quran. He mentions it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Majority of the places Allah does that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says كاف ها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا. And what that means is هذه الذي نتلوه, this which we recite في هذه الآيات, in these verses, is the what? It's قصة. It is the story, it is رَحْمَةُ رَبِّكَ, رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ, it's your, the mercy of your Lord, Ya Muhammad, that Allah تبارك وتعالى is telling you the story of زكريا عليه السلام. Because Allah تبارك وتعالى mentions in Surah Al-An'am, He says وَزَكَرِيَّا وَيَحْيَا وَعِيسَى وَإِلْيَاسَ كُلٌّ مِّنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. نبي الله زكريا, نبي الله يحيى, and Isa and Ilyas are from the righteous creations of Allah تبارك وتعالى. And our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's been told about these prophets. ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا. يعني this which we're reciting on you, these verses, Muhammad, are the قصة رحمة ربك, the mercy of your Lord, يا محمد, عبده, the slave of his, زكريا عليه السلام. And نبي الله زكريا, as the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told us in the hadith of Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih that Zakariya was a carpenter. The Prophet said, كان زكريا نجارا. زكريا عليه السلام was a carpenter. إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا. يعني إذ نادى زكريا ربه. Nabiullah Zakariya called unto his Lord. Nida'an khafiyan means wasa'alahu binida'in khafiyin 'anil nas. He called unto his Lord. He begged his Lord, but he made it with a volume and a sound that was very low. Khafi means something that's low, that's not yani too loud. Brothers and sisters, rahmati rabbika, what does it mean? What is the murad of rahmati rabbika? Ama rahm bi rahmati llahi li Zakariya. What does it actually mean? It means Allah accepting ijabatu iyahu hina da'ahu wa sa'alahu alwalada. Allah's mercy unto Zakariya when Zakariya called unto his Lord, supplicated, invoked unto his Lord, and asked him for a child. The acceptance of his dua is what Allah is referring to here as rahmati rabbika. And the scholars that said that that is what it means is Al-Wahidi, Al-Shawkani, Ibn Ashur, and others. They mentioned that. Okay? Idhna da rabbahuna, Ibn Ashur, he said, Idhna da rabbahu, it's the dharaf. Li rahmati, ay rahmati Allahi iyahu fi dhalika al-waqt. It means, when he called unto his Lord, rahmati, it means, ay rahmati Allahi, the mercy of Allah, on Zakariya fi dhalika al-waqt, at that time. Or you can make it a badal, he said, min dhikru, ay dhikru dhalika al-waqti. It can be both, no problem. You can make it a dharf, or you can make it a badal. Ibn Ashur mentions that in his tafsir. Idh nada rabbahu, when he called unto his Lord, nida'an khafiyya. What is it that he said? قال ربي إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك ربي شقيا. He said, ربي, my Lord. نبي الله زكريا, he said, قال, he means, أي قال زكريا, يا ربي, my Lord, وهن العظم مني, it means رق عظمي, my bones have become soft, وضعفت قوة بدني, the strength and the physical ability of mine has become low. I'm not as strong as I used to be. I'm becoming weaker. I'm becoming old. I'm becoming fragile now. وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا. يعني what he means, وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا, he means, أي وَانْتَشَرَ بَيَاضُ الشَّيْبِ فِي رَأْسِي. The whiteness has overcome my hair. Now my hair is all white. It's all gray now. وَلَمْ أَكُنْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّي شَقِيًّا. وَلَمْ أَكُنْ, I haven't been. حِينَ أَدْعُوكَ مِنْ قَبْلُ, when I supplicated to you before, my Lord, Ya Rabbi, my Lord, I was never خَائِبًا مَحْرُومًا مَرْدُودَ الدَّعْوَةِ. You've never returned my supplication. I was never a person you prevented them from what they wanted. Rather, you, O Allah, بَلْ عَوَّدْتَنِي إِجَابَةَ دَعْوَتِي وَقَضَاءَ حَاجَتِي. You fulfilled my needs. Whenever I came to you, O Allah, you were always there for me. You always gave me what I needed, Ya Rabbi. Let me go back to a verse before. Nabiullah Zakariya, he's calling unto Allah. إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ, he supplicates to his Lord. نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا, but Allah referred to his supplication as a what? It was a supplication which was khafi, was hidden. What does it mean? The scholars, what was the reason why he hid his dua, supplication? The scholars, they differed. اِخْتُلِفَ فِي سَبَبِ إِخْفَائِ هَذَا النِّدَاءِ. Why did he actually choose to hide the supplication and keep it private and put the volume down? Why? Some of the scholars, they said, أَخْفَاهُ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ, he concealed it from his people. لِأَلَّا يُلَامَ عَلَى مَسْأَلَةِ الْوَلَدِ عِنْدَ كِبَرِ السِّنِّ. So they don't scold him and shame him for asking for a child at a very old age. If you want to look, يعني, he didn't want people to say, look at this old man. انظروا إلى هذا الشيخ يسأل على كبره الولد. Look at this old man, he's asking a child at this particular age, at this old age. Na'am. Some of the scholars, they said, لِأَنَّ الْإِخْفَاءَ أَقْرَبُ إِلَى الْإِخْلَاصِ وَأَبْعَدُ مِنَ الرِّيَاءِ. Some of the scholars, they said, the reason why he put his volume lower is because that is closest to sincerity and it's far from showing off. Some scholars, they said, the reason why he put his volume lower is because إِنَّهُ دَعَى فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. Is that he made dua at night time when people can't hear. Okay? And he was in prostration. And so nighttime, people sleeping, he put his volume down. And he was in prostration. وَقِيلَ غَيْرُ ذَلِكَ And other scholars have said other than that. You can go to Tafsir Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, Tafsir Ibn Juzay, you can go to Tafsir al-Qurtubi, you can go to even Tafsir al-Sam'ani. All of those great scholars, they mentioned it. Nabilah Zakariya is begging his Lord. And he's, first of all, he's explaining his situation to Allah. He's saying, Ya Rabbi, my Lord. Ya Rabbi, he's saying, my Lord. وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي أَيْ رَقَّ عَظْمِي My bones have become weak. يعني وضعفت قوة بدني My body has now become fragile. I'm old. I've touched age. وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا And my hair has now, nearly all of it has become white. And also, Ya Rab, وَلَمْ أَكُنْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيًّا I have never been. لَمْ أَكُنْ حِينَ أَدْعُوكَ Whenever I would come to supplicate to you, من قبل before, Ya Rabbi, my Lord, I have never been خائباً Mahrooman, Marduda Dawa. I've never been someone whose dua has been rejected. I have been turned back and I've not been given what I wanted. Rather, my Lord, Bal Awatani Ijabata Dawati. Oh Allah, you've always aided me and supported me and you've given me what I asked for. Waqada Ahajati, you fulfilled my need for me, Ya Rabbi. And then he went on to say, Wa inni khiftul mawaliya min wara'i wa kanat imra'ati 'aqira. فهب لي من لدنك وليا He said وإني خفت He says أي وإني يا ربي My Lord خفت I'm scared أن يضيع أقاربي من بعد موتي الدين I am scared my Lord that my relatives and my close family members they would forsake the religion the religion gets forsaken أن يضيع أقاربي that my relatives my close ones that they forsake after my death الدين, the religion, والعلم, and knowledge, ولا يقوم بحقهما, and they don't stand up for the responsibility. Al-Imam Al-Wahidi, he mentions this in his Kitab Al-Wasit. Also, Hatta Zamakhshari mentions it, Qurtubi mentions it, Ibn Taymiyyah emphasized greatly this meaning in his Kitab Minhaj Sunan Nabawiyyah in the fourth volume. He mentioned, Ibn Kathir also mentions it, As-Si'di also mentions it, Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqitubi mentions it in his Adwa'ul Bayan. Ibn Kathir, he said, Rahimahullah, وَجْهُ خَوْفِي أَنَّوْ خَشِيَ أَنْ يَتَصَرَّفُ مِنْ بَعْدِي فِي النَّاسِ تَصَرُّفًا سَيِّئًا He was scared that after his death, that they would deal with the people after his death in a very bad way. That's what he was scared of. Brothers and sisters, look at what these prophets are scared of. And they're worried of. And what a lot of people today who are dying are worried of. My money, my this, my that. They don't care about what their children are going to be and their families are going to be in terms of their religion after their death. That's why he said, وَإِنِّي خِفْتُ الْمَوَالِيَ مِنْ وَرَائِي مَوَالِيَ here, he means أَقَارِبِي, my close relatives. I'm scared. And يُضَيِّعُوا that they forsake بَعْدَ مَوْتِي الدِّينَ وَالْعِلْمَ that they forsake the religion and everything. Also, وَكَانَتِ امْرَاتِي عَاقِرًا And my wife, she's aqima, la talidu aslan. My wife can never give birth. She can't have children aslan. Even when she was young, she couldn't have children. So that shows that Nabilah Zakariya stayed with her, even though she couldn't have any children. Fahabli min ladunka waliya. Fahabli here, he means farzuqni, oh Allah, give me. Ya Rabbi. Min indika, from your side. Give me what? Waladin, a child. Yaqumu bid-deen, who stands up for this religion. مِنْ بَعْدِ أَفْتَمِ حَقَّ الْقِيَامِ And he stands for it the way it should be stood up for. Al-Imam Ibn Jarir al-Tabari mentions that view. Al-Biqa'i also mentions it. Al-Rahman Nasir al-Sa'idi mentions that. Even Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqitiyyu mentions that in his Adwa'ul Bayan. This is what he asks for. He said, Ya Rabbi, O my Lord, give me. Allow me to have a child after your death. مِنْ لَدُنْكَ Ibn Ashur, he says, مِنْ لَدُنْكَ What it means is, أي من عندك from your side أي من عند الله from your side oh Allah here he when he says oh Allah from you the child always comes from Allah so where else could it come from this Ibn Ashur mentions this is عندية خاصة he says it's not just a child like that he means a specific child Ya Rabbi with qualities that are specific because Nabilah Zakariya look what he says Ibn Ashur he says لأن المتكلم يعلم أن كل شيء من عند الله بتقديره he knows everything is from Allah it comes from his side وخلقه and Allah creates everything So why would he say min ladunka, from your side? Here it shows dalla ala annahu sa'ala waliyan. He asked Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, a wali, ghayra jarin. He was asking for a particular type of child, a righteous child, a noble child. That's what he was asking for. That is what he was begging Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentioned surah to Ali Imran. Qala rabbi habli min ladunka dhurriyatan tayyibatan innaka sami'ud du'a. Also in surah al-Anbiya, وزكريا إذ نادى ربه ربي لا تذرني فردا وأنت خير الوارثين. And here in Surah Maryam he says, يرثني ويرث من آل يعقوب وجعله ربي رضيا. يرثني, what does he mean? يرث علمي ونبوتي. He's going to inherit knowledge and prophecy from me. ويرث is also going to inherit what? Min ajdadihi, he's going to inherit from his grandfathers, his forefathers. Al Yaqub, al ilma, wal nubuwah, he's going to inherit from them. Fayakunu nabiyan, fayakunu nabiyan, so he's going to be a prophet. Da'iyan ila Allah qa'iman bi dinihi. Waj'alhu rabbi radiya. Oh Allah, make him what? Waj'al waladi. Oh Allah, make my child. Ya rabbi, my lord, mardiyan, when you are pleased with indak. وَعِنْدَ عِبَادِكَ, and make him one who is being, he's pleased, the people are pleased with him. صَالِحًا فِي دِينِهِ وَخُلُقِهِ وَأَعْمَالِهِ, he's righteous in his speech and in his actions and everything he does. That's what Nabiullah Zakariya asked for. Brothers and sisters, this teaches us what we want from children. What our aim is, we want righteous children. When he said in Surah Ali Imran, قَالَ رَبِّ هَبْلِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ ذُرِّيَّةً طَيِّبَةً. إِنَّكَ سَمِعُ الدُّعَاءِ. We don't want just want any children. We want righteous children. When he said, Rabbi, when Zakariya, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ. And when he said in Surah Maryam, يَرِثُنِي وَيَرِثُ مِنْ آلِ يَعْقُوبُ وَجَعَلْهُ رَبِّ رَضِيًّا. He's going to inherit prophecy and knowledge. And also, Ya Rabb, make him one that you're pleased with and the creation are pleased with. And Allah gave him that. He gave him Yahya ibn Zakariya. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like, and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.